Detecting lung cancer drugs can kill HIV cells. Doctors at the Pitié Salpêtrière Hospital, APHP Hospital in Paris, have found the first evidence that a drug used to treat lung, kidney and skin cancer can kill the cells. HIV infection in AIDS patients. In the study, a 51-year-old man diagnosed with HIV positive in 1995 and diagnosed with lung cancer in May 2015, has been treated with nivolumab, administered by Bristol Myers Squibb. Sold as Optivo. The results of the platelet containment of HIV sharply and consistently without the use of basic drugs. Patients were injected with 31 doses of nivolumab every 2 weeks since December 2016. After the first injection, the level of HIV infection increased continuously until the 45th day, then decreased. Doctors explained that the activity of the immune system in the body has increased. By the 120th day, treatment results shows that the HIV burial had decreased sharply. The case has been reported in the Annals of Oncology, in which doctors have reportedly applied similar studies to another patient using Optivo but without any effect on HIV. Dr. Jean-Philippe Spano, MD, professor of cancer medicine at the hospital, said, "It is still very cautious because it is a single case," he added. The first demonstration showed a marked decrease in HIV volume. For his part, Cardiff University infectious disease specialist Andrea Friedman said the findings were very encouraging, but cautious. Over the years, scientists have been trying to find ways to get rid of HIV, with the aim of eliminating it completely and curing AIDS patients. The joint United Nations Program on HIV/AIDS, UNAIDS, says that global HIV treatment over the past 15 years has made great strides, accounting for 57% of all cases being treated. The challenge now is to get 16 million untreated patients, including about 919,000 children, to receive treatment as soon as possible. In a letter published in the cancer journal Annals of Oncology, researchers led by Professor Jean-Philippe Spano, head of the Medical Oncology Department at Pitié Salpêtrière Hospital APHP in Paris, France, report that while treating an HIV-infected lung cancer patient with the cancer drug nivolumab, they observed a drastic and persistent decrease in the reservoirs of cells in the body where the human immunodeficiency virus, HIV, is able to hide away from attack by antiretroviral therapy. These reservoirs of HIV-infected cells are found in the immune system in organs such as the brain, bone marrow and genital tract. They lie dormant and cannot be eliminated by antiretroviral therapy, nor by the weakened immune system, so that if treatment is stopped at any time, the virus starts to replicate and infect more cells again, while the immune system cannot suppress this rebound of HIV infection. If scientists could find a way of clearing away the reservoirs of HIV-infected cells, then it might enable them to eradicate the virus completely, making it possible to cure HIV patients. HIV primarily infects CD4 T cells, which are a type of white blood cell that plays an important role in regulating the immune response. When under attack from HIV, they not only become infected but also exhausted, meaning they are less able to fight the infection. Professor in the Department of Medical Oncology, Institut Gustave Roussy, Villejuif, France, commented, "Although this is a single case study, it is an exciting result. Anti-HIV drugs usually stop virus replication but don't cure the patients who still have reservoirs of the virus. This study generates the hypothesis that drugs that make the virus disappear could, perhaps, cure patients. The patient will be treated with more nivolumab later this month and his cancer will also be assessed then. For the moment, he is doing quite well and doesn't show any signs of disease, even though the cancer is progressing slowly, which suggests it is not optimally controlled," said Professor Spano.